Do you know when you subscribe to an observable, a stream gets automatically created so that it can handle the emission? And this thing can cause memory leaks and eat up our system resources. That's why you may see a warning in IntelliJ every time you subscribe saying the result of subscribe has been ignored. Our job is to gracefully handle the subscriptions when we are done with it. Namaste everyone, in this video, we will be showing exactly how you can deal with those subscriptions when we are done with it using Disposable. So let's get right into it. As you can see, we have got an observable created with interval. And it emits every second. And we pause the thread for 3 seconds here just to check whether it works or not. If you don't understand observable.interval, we have got a dedicated episode on that. You can check it from the card that you can see right now, or link will be in the description of this video. Now let's check to see what this subscribe method returns. And as you can see, it returns disposable. And disposable here, nothing but an interface, has this obvious method called dispose, which is there to dispose of the resources, and very useful method called isDisposed to check whether a subscription has been disposed or still in use. So now that you know it returns a disposable, we can now call its dispose method at any point of time to stop emissions. Now let's save the return disposable to a variable in here and dispose it after 3 seconds. And now let's pause the thread for 3 more seconds to check whether it emits any more item or not. And run. I don't know if you have noticed, but it emits the items for 3 seconds. And after 3 more seconds, the program finished. But it did not print anything in the console in that 3 minutes. If you want, you can download the source code from the GitHub link given below and run to check how it works. Okay, you all know that subscribe method not only take those on next, on error and on complete. It also takes an instance of observer interface, which basically has all of this method all together. And if you haven't watched our observer introduction video, you should watch this, especially if you don't understand what's going on here. Now disposing of here is a little bit tricky. You may say that let's save the disposable to a variable like we did before and dispose. But wait my friend, this subscribe method does not return disposable, as it has a return type of void. But don't worry, it has a method called onSubscribe which basically gives you a disposable. This is the same method that we did not want it to discuss earlier. You will see how we use it today. Let's save this disposable to a variable. And there we go. All of them have access to the disposable right now. Now we can dispose of them any point in time. Let's do a test here. Do something crazy, like if the integer is equals to 3, let's dispose. Great, let's run. And there we go, it prints from 1 to 3. Don't be surprised saying we tell this to dispose right after it finds 3. This simply means after you find 3, the onNext will not be called again.
This method is almost the same as the previous one. So when you pass an instance of observer, RxJava thinks that the observer will handle the disposal. Now if you really want RxJava to handle this and gives you a disposable in return, then you can slightly modify this method. Instead of creating observer instance, you need to create resource observer. Which does not have this onSubscribe method for obvious reason. You will soon know why. So let's remove this method. And instead of subscribe, use subscribe with. And that's it. You can save the result of this in a disposable variable. If you check the subscribe method, it returns a generic observer. And in our case, the observer is resource observer, which is a special type of observer which implements disposable. So that you get the instance of disposable, you can dispose anytime. And also, subscribe on subscribe method does not make any sense here. So now that you understand how we can dispose, let's understand a very important thing called composite disposable. Important because you may need to use this in various points of time in your code base. So as you can see, we have two disposables in here. And we want to dispose all of them at a certain point in time. We have two disposables here right now, but it can be more than that in the actual code base. So disposing each of them by calling dispose is not a clean approach, and also we may forget to dispose a subscription and that may create unfortunate bugs. So to avoid that, we can create a class called composite disposable, actually not a class, an instance of composite observable or disposable, and we can add our disposable right after we create the subscription. It has this add all method where you can add all of the disposables at once, or you can use the add method to add one by one. I'm going to use the add all right now because I have more than one disposable. And instead of calling dispose one by one, you can use composite disposable.dispose. And if you want to delete any disposable from the composite disposable, you have that option as well. Just call the delete method and pass the specific disposable that you would like to remove from the set of composite disposable. I am removing the disposable 1. So I expect to see all the emissions from disposable 1. Let's run. And there we go, we can see all the output from disposable 1 and it was not disposed, and disposable 2 only prints the item for 3 seconds.
Now the question is, why should we care to call the dispose method? Any subscription that goes through onComplete and finish emission may not require you to call dispose, as RxJava will handle it. But for some reason and the sake of good practices, you can dispose them whenever we are done with the subscription. And also there are some specific observable which never calls onComplete. For those, you can call the dispose method to free up resources so that garbage collector can start doing its work. So it will prevent the memory leaks from happening. This will be much clearer when we will apply this knowledge to a real application. And we are going to cover that as well. So to stay tuned, subscribe to our channel and hit that bell icon so that you don't miss the videos that we upload every Sunday. And if you have any doubt or questions regarding disposables and composite disposables, then comment below or please message me on any of my social handles. And I'll try my best to answer your query. So it's Mithu here signing off. Thank you for stopping by. See you next Sunday.